load shedding again, which means the UPS is running, and that also means that it is beeping, and it's quite a loud and incessant beeping. And while it's possible to turn the beeping off, that setting is lost when the power is removed completely. For example, physically moving this UPS around and plugging it and unplugging it from the cables. So in order to make this stop beeping, we'll have to open it up.
Okay, so time to open this up and see if we can get at that little speaker that is responsible for quite the beep. Of course, you need a long screwdriver. Three out of four. Oh. Clearly it's coming loose anyway. Ah. That might just be our little beeper right there. I don't really see anything else that could be a beeper. In fact, it's labeled BZ01, buzzer 01. Irritating little thing that it is. Getting easier. I see this PCB is held in by various tabs here. So we can try and this PCB is held in by all these little tabs here, which can be pressed in. Grab the flat screwdriver. Ta-da! So, the plan is to desolder this buzzer. Okay, so my plan is to desolder the two legs of the buzzer and effectively just remove it. If it had been sticking out quite a bit further from the board, could have just cut one leg, which you could have done with the side cutters if you don't have soldering tools. But what I think we'll do is use some solder wick and maybe a touch of solder to get it going. The soldering iron to remove it. And also, if you have a solder sucker, you could also use that as well. If you don't have solder wick, you can use basically just stranded copper wire. It's often like in speakers and things like that. Any really flexible wire, if it's very easily bent, then it's probably multi-strand, and that effectively works the same. So let's just try to take this off. Okay. You can see it's wicking up the it's already wicking up the solder there. It's gone a silver there. Trick is to heat up the wick and the bit that you're trying to desolder at the same time. I like to just push on the solder wick onto the terminal that I'm trying to get loose. Okay, so the one side is actually completely loose already, and the other side needs a bit more. And then look at that. There you go. That is the bane of my existence right there. Yes, I do know how to shut this thing up, even from Linux, etc. The problem with this device is that it doesn't matter what you set it to using the software, when it loses power completely, for example, just unplugging it to do this work on, then it forgets that setting. And the next time the power goes out, which is quite often when you have load shedding in South Africa, then you have problems of the beeping incessantly variety. Just try and put this back in nicely. Just put it back together and give it a test. Amazingly, that was quite easy after the first fiddle with it. Even got the USB port over here on the front lined up, which is good. I was a little bit worried about that. And the button is lining up and activating the switch behind it, so that's good. Now we can plug in our wires. Seems about right. Helps when you don't have it sitting on a screw. It's much more stable. Maybe give it a quick test. See if it beeps incessantly. So now it's just a case of putting our screws back in there. So one thing I noticed, I'm a big fan of doing things diagonally, so if that's the first one, then the second one will be over there, and then three and four, or four and three, I suppose. And other trick is you can just go slightly backwards first with the screw, i.e. anti-clockwise, before tightening it. That helps align the point of the screw with the hole that's already there. Because these are going to plastic, I'd rather have them in the same hole than trying to cut a new one, which could end up being loose then. These are self-tapping screws. Okay, fairly tight, not too tight, don't want to break it. It's check everything is tight. There you go. It's just the USB port cover, and yeah, got to plug it back in. But just to demonstrate, now it's only the sound of the fan and no longer an irritating buzzer noise from this little chap. And it doesn't seem to be throwing an error, which is good. I suppose these things are not that intelligent to be figuring out that this piece is missing. Does make me slightly curious as to what the resistance is of this thing. This little this one says seems to say 41 ohms, so call it 40 ohms. Let's double check that again. Yeah, 41, 42. But just in case the thing really was smart and checking the resistance to make sure the buzz is there, not that that would make much sense because it's a non-essential part. Yay. One other thing, if you don't have a soldering iron, instead of clippers, some people just use a screwdriver and stab it until the little buzzer is dead. I don't think I'd like to do that purely because of the mechanical force involved on the PCB. The printed circuit board beneath this could start cracking traces or just, you know, having other components pop off it because they're being flexed to the point where it's no longer straight. So, anyway, if you're desperate, maybe.